Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Android Studio, that is Android Studio version Ladybug, on our Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Android project and how to run that on our Android phone itself. So in this video, I am going to discuss how to use your own Android phone itself to run all the Android projects that you are creating over Android Studio. So you'll not need any emulator or anything. So you're going to save a lot of space on your laptop itself, on your laptop hard disk, and it will be very smooth as well. You're not going to need any emulator. So I'm going to show you how to use your very phone itself to run Android project that you're creating over Android Studio. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you this video is going to be really helping you. And this video going to be a bit long as well, so watch the video till the end, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. And I'm also on Instagram now, you can also follow me over there as well. So now to install Android Studio, you need to first simply go to favorite browser, and then you need to search over here Android Studio download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this developer.android.com as a first search result. So to click on this download Android Studio, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Android Studio. So this developer.android.com/studio link I'm going to provide right in our description. Once you are here, you'll see that our download button for Android Studio Ladybug is available. So if you are watching this video much later, you might see a different version. That time it would be a different name altogether, but this download Android Studio will be there. After that, there could be another name. Don't worry, whatever steps I am showing on this video will be pretty much same. So just need to hit this download button, whichever version it is. I am showing it for Ladybug version. When you will be watching, there could be different version, alright? But process will be pretty much same. Just simply click on this download button. So download Android Studio Ladybug, scroll down, accept the license agreement, and click on the download button. And immediately we'll see that our file is rightly started downloading. You can see it is rightly started downloading, right? I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that the same file is already been downloaded over here. And the file size is 1.13 gigabyte. So it's quite a huge file. Just, you know, simply click on, double click on the installer to start installing your Android Studio. So it will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory and our browser as well. So welcome to Android Studio setup. Just simply click on next over here. So here it is telling whether you'd like to also install Android virtual device. So that is what I am not going to recommend you installing any virtual device, because I'm pretty much sure that everybody are already using at least one Android phone, right? So you all must be having one Android phone. So you can use that phone itself. Why you need another virtual device and make your system heavy, right? You can use your phone itself. So I'm going to show you all of that in this video itself. You don't need to worry. So just uncheck that and use your own Android phone. Do not use any virtual device. All right, just simply select the Android Studio itself and click on next. So this is where our Android Studio is going to be installed. Everything is fine. Click on next. Android Studio folder that they are going to create. Everything is fine. Install. So our installation is rightly begun. So you can always click on show details and you can see how it is installing. Alright. So it's going to take some time, a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I am posting a lot of coding related videos. Do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel if you are interested. So let's minimize this and wait for a couple of minutes over here. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Android Studio setup is rightly done. Just simply click on next over here. So start Android Studio is rightly selected. Click on finish. And there you go. So first it will ask whether you'd like to send anonymous statistics to them. You can always click on send user statistics to Google, not a big deal. That's going to help them to make this product much robust. So everything is fine. Welcome to Android Studio. Just simply click on next. So So here under install type, you'll see there are a couple of options. One is standard, so that's going to flat install everything, or else the one that I'm going to recommend you is do custom installation and click on next. And here, as I was talking about at the very beginning of the video, we don't need any virtual device, right? Because we are all having Android phone. Why need another virtual device? So uncheck that. You can also uncheck this Android emulator, because anyway you are not using any emulator, right? And next we are also going to uncheck this performance Intel action, because that also used for creating a virtual device. So we don't need these last three. We only need the latest version of SDK, which is version 14, and Android SDK basically. I mean Android SDK version 14. Alright, so this only. So after that, just simply click on next. So again, click on next to proceed. So these are all what it's going to install. Click on next. So you need to accept the license agreement. Select this and click on accept. You need to also select this and click on accept. This is just a license agreement. You can always read this and click on finish. So that's going to immediately start downloading lot of files from internet and going to install it. So you can see it is rightly started doing that. It's going to take some time. You need to have active internet connection for this. So just wait for a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Android SDK is actually installed. So everything is good. Our Android SDK is updated now. Everything is fine. Just simply click on finish. And that's going to launch our Android Studio. So welcome to Android Studio. So here you can create a new project. So just simply click on this new project to create a brand new project on Android Studio Ladybug. Just let's select one empty activity and click on next. So here you need to provide your project name. So let's give the project name as Hello Android, and package name I'm going to keep it default. So this is where our Android project is going to be created. So within Android Studio projects, it's going to create our project called Hello Android. So everything is totally fine. And here minimum SDK is version 7. So you can see about 97.4% of the devices, this Hello Android project going to be supported. So that is what we want. We always want, maximum number of devices get supported the project that we are creating. So Android 7 is totally fine. And the language default, they have selected Kotlin DSL. If you want to change it to Groovy, you can do that. I'm going to keep the default one, or the recommended one, that is Kotlin DSL, and click on finish. So that's going to start creating your Android Studio project. So Hello Android project is rightly started creating. So again, it's going to take some time. It's going to fetch a lot of files, libraries, everything from internet, and then it's going to install it. So you can always, by the time that gets done, you can always read this what new in Ladybug. Let's just maximize this, and you can always read this article. Alright, so it's going to take some time. You can see that our Gradle project sync is in progress now. So it is importing a lot of files from internet, libraries, everything, and going to sync our Gradle. So you need to have active internet connection. If you are seeing that it is halting, it is not doing anything, don't worry, it will take some time. It's going to take some time to create this project, to prepare everything for you. So it will take some time. You can see this main activity.kt file is also opened over here. So this is our demo code that they have already provided, and this is our project Hello Android. So on that project we have a folder called app, and there we have src folder, and that has a main folder, and then java com example, that is our package Hello Android. And on UI we have this main activity.kt, and that file is also opened over here, right? So it's going to take some time. Let's wait for some time. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Gradle is rightly synced. So nothing is running over here, everything is fine. Our main activity.kt file is also opened. What's new in Ladybug? Let's, you know, minimize this so that we have a clear screen. And you can always expand this app, and you can expand this Kotlin plus Java folder over here. Let's expand this, then expand our package, which is com.example.helloandroid, and you will get this UI.theme, and then we have a mainactivity.kt. So when you double click on that, we'll get this file opened over here, mainactivity.kt. Right, so here is our code. So if you click on this split screen, it's going to show you the design over here. So for that, first you need to click on this build and refresh, and it's going to start building our project, and it's going to show you the design part over here. So let's wait for a minute, and there you go, you can see the output, right? Hello Android. So basically, you know, I am using i3 processor, i3 11th generation processor. So as many of my, you know, students are keep on asking that, sir, I have i3, so whether I'll be able to install Android Studio, whether I'll be able to run Android Studio and all that. So yes, you can do that. Okay, I am currently doing in i3 itself, so you can do that. So only thing is, probably you will need SSD will be very helpful, as you know, probably if you are using hard disk, then you might see some sort of lag issue. But if you are using SSD, I'd say it is totally fine. SSD 8GB of RAM and i3 11th gen or 10th gen will actually do. Alright. So yeah, so here we can see the Hello Android on the design plate. So let's say you want to, you know, change something here. Like, let's say we have Hello, right? So let's say we want to change with Hello instead of Hello. Let's say we are changing with Hi. So as we change that, immediately you can see it is compiling. And here it is loading, and you can see the output, Hi Android, right? So whatever change you are making, immediately it's going to reflect it over here. So now the question is how we can run this project on our Android phone, right? So for that, the first thing that you need to do is, you need to, you know, pick up your USB cable, and you need to connect that in your laptop over that cable and your phone, right? So this is, I think everybody has done that. So you need to connect your laptop with the USB. I'm currently doing that. And in phone, it's going to ask you that whether you'd like to allow access to your phone data. So you need to click on allow over here. And as soon as you do that, it will again ask you whether you'd like to allow USB debugging. You need to again do allow for that. And when you do that, you can see that Samsung phone, SM-AM12-7G, phone is actually gets, you know, recognized over here, right? And when you get that device recognized within Android Studio, it click on this run button. So when you click on run button, what happens in the background is it you know, going to start building our project. And if it gets successfully builded, so let's say you don't have any errors on your program, so then only it will get successfully builded. Okay, so when it gets successfully builded, it's going to push that code, you know, as an APK format into our phone. So in our phone, you will be able to see shortly that this, you know, Hello Android app going to be installed there and going to be also launched over there, right? So it takes some time, so let's wait for some time. So you can see that our installed successfully, so Gradle build is finished, and in our phone you can see the output, Hi Android, right? So you can clearly see that that is coming. So in this way, you can easily install Android Studio, you can easily, you know, create Android project, you can easily use your Android phone itself to, you know, to do all sort of testing that you are developing within Android Studio. So only one thing that I'd like to mention is, probably you might not get straightforwardly connected with your phone. So that's because probably the developer option might not be enabled. So for that, you need to go to settings over here, and need to, you know, scroll down, and here you can see that we already have developer option enabled, right? So that is because I have enabled that. So I am going to show you how you can enable that. So you need to have this developer option enabled. So only when it is enabled, then only you'll be able to connect with your laptop. Okay, So for that, into, you know, let's first disabled a developer option, then only I'll show you. So now I am disabling it. So I have disabled it. So let's go back. So now you not no longer going to see that developer option, right? Only you are seeing only about phone. So you need to click on this about phone, and then you need to click on this build number. So you have to keep on clicking on this build number, then it will show you this the pattern. So it will give the pattern, and now you can see that developer mode is turned on. So you have to keep on clicking this build number for some time. So it doesn't matter what phone you are using, you basically understood the point, right? You need to go to your about section, then go to software information, and then you need to click on the build number. So you can see on Google also, like, how you can enable a developer option on your phone. So probably if you are using Redmi, you probably need to sign into some sort of account, they will probably ask you. So it varies from phone to phone, but you basically understood the point, right? The point is you need to have developer option enabled. Once you have that, you go back and you can see that developer option is right now there. So go there, and here you need to again scroll down and to enable this USB debugging. Enable that. Click on OK. So once you have that, then only it will ask you that pop-up. So accept this, allow, and you'll be able to see your phone right on your Android Studio itself. All right. So that is another point that I wanted to mention. So probably in my previous videos, I have already talked about this. Probably you might not have seen those things. So that's why I wanted to repeat that again. All right. So yeah. So that's how you enabled your developer option, and you enabled your phone as a developer option, and you connect that over your Android Studio. All right. So yeah, that's pretty much all about this video. I know this video is a bit long, but I hope I was able to help you. So I was able to explain all the things related to Android Studio and how to create project and all that and use your Android phone itself. Right. So that's basically all about this video. I have also started a Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And you can also follow a lot of our other tutorials. Like recently I have posted one video on how to prepare a free e-commerce website using WordPress. So you can follow, you know, these videos as well. So you'll get all this playlist under our playlist. So do, you know, navigate our channel and follow some of my other tutorials as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.